You are listening to the audio production of 9 Lies That Will Destroy Your Marriage and the Truths That Will Save It and Set It Free by Robert Paul and Greg Smalley. Published by Focus on the Family in alliance with Tyndale House Publishers. The book is read by Lyle Blaker. Introduction. Your Journey to a Better Marriage. Jim and Mary have been married 18 years. But say they now feel more like friends than lovers. "It's like we're roommates or business partners," says Jim, "not husband and wife." They want to be closer and go deeper, but they don't know how to get there. According to their many friends, Marissa and Todd are warm, outgoing, and talkative. But when the two of them try to talk to each other, bombs explode. Even simple discussions about their daily schedules can rapidly veer off track, as unresolved conflicts from a month or a decade earlier resurface and inflame powerful passions. Roger and Brittany both hoped that marriage would be calmer the second time around. Both left their first marriages because they said their partners subjected them to verbal attacks and abuse. But now, a few years into their marriage, they're too emotionally self-protective to risk sharing openly and honestly with each other. Beverly and Andrew have been married for 13 years. Everything seemed perfect for a long time. Now things are tense, ever since Andrew found out that Beverly, who was 15 years younger, had an affair with a coworker. She has repeatedly apologized, but a cloud of distance and distrust remains. These four couples are struggling. Their marriages began with love and hope, but have since spiraled downhill. Now it's a Monday morning, and they're all sitting on big, comfy couches in a meeting room at Focus on the Family's Hope Restored Marriage Intensive in Branson, Missouri. They're hoping for a miracle, and as the leaders of this week's intensive, we're praying that they experience one. We're not miracle workers, but God is. We've worked with more than 7,000 couples over the last 20 years as retreat leaders and trained therapists. We've reached even more people through our talks and books. All these men and women have provided a type of marriage lab for us. And what we keep learning is amazing. The results have been nothing short of miraculous. Most of the couples who come to us for therapy are in real crisis, many on the brink of divorce. Yet some of our research indicates that more than 80% remain married 2 years after they let us help them. We've brought together some of our top marriage insights and tools in the pages that follow. This isn't theory. It's practical wisdom that comes from being able to walk alongside people who struggle to make their marriages stronger. In fact, these are the very tools and strategies our entire team uses in their own lives. If you've been struggling in your marriage, we pray you may find a miracle or two of your own. If not, we know that these insights and tools can make a good marriage even better. Why we love lies about love. Each couple is unique and faces unique challenges in marriage. But in our decades of working with couples, both in marriages that are healthy and in those that are struggling, we've repeatedly encountered the same major problems happening over and over and over again. Yes. The individual circumstances of each marriage may be unique, but the problems we see weakening and destroying marriages are often common and predictable. That's because one of the biggest problems we see is that men and women grow up learning lies about love, lies generally taught by well-meaning people. Then they put these love lies into practice in their marriages, which prevents them from experiencing the wonder and beauty of real love. Why would people build a marriage on a foundation of attractive but destructive lies instead of building on the solid foundation of God's loving truth? These lies are taught as truth and can be very subtle. Sometimes they're even partially true. The problem is, they result in relational strategies that cannot actually work, and we don't realize it. And if we're using fundamentally flawed strategies we've been told are right and will work, what are we left to assume is the problem when these strategies inevitably fail? The people themselves. Many of these marriage myths have now permeated our culture, filtering down even into our churches and our dating and marriage rituals. Sadly, we allow these insidious ideas to burrow deep down in the foundations of our marriages and fatally weaken the whole structure. In this book, we will be exploring the biggest lies we've seen at work in people's relationships. We think of them as big, ugly, hungry termites designed to devour and destroy the foundations of love and marriage. For example, Chapter 2 will shine a light on the 1 plus 1 equals 1 lie. This particular myth may seem attractive when heard in just the right circumstances. For example, when Tom Cruise looks passionately at Renee Zellweger in the movie Jerry Maguire and declares, "You complete me." Or when Elvis Presley belts out the chorus of his 1956 hit, "I want you, I need you, I love you." The 1 plus 1 equals 1 lie sounds romantic, like something you might see in a greeting card or love note. But we've talked to many spouses who started off wanting to generously provide the key ingredients to fulfill and complete their incomplete partners. Yet after years of genuine effort, they don't know why they appear to be failing, and their spouses still feel unfulfilled. We've seen the sad legacy of this attractive but destructive lie in hundreds of couples unknowingly caught in the webs of codependency. The belief held by many spouses that they must look to their partners to find their true happiness, sense of self-worth, and identity. In Chapter 9, we'll explore the popular lie that says fights between marriage partners are natural and unavoidable, but that everything will be okay if everyone just remembers to fight fair and make up afterward. We have personally seen the destructive impact of this lie in hundreds of couples who can't settle conflicts without going ballistic and attacking or tearing each other down, leaving both partners emotionally and sometimes physically wounded and scarred. As we show you the destructive power of these major marriage lies in people's lives, we will point towards stronger foundations to build on. Foundations based on our Creator's will and design for marriage. Because the lies we've loved and lived with all our lives don't suddenly disappear overnight once we see the light, we'll also lead you through some of the techniques and tools we've used ourselves and with many couples we've counseled. If you want a marriage that's stronger, more loving, and more resilient, these time-tested tools will help you make steady progress. Consider the source. We've worked with people of all religions and creeds, but most of our work is with Christian couples, and when we work with believers, we talk about the spiritual forces and powers that are at play in our lives. That same Christian view will also be our vantage point for this book. As you will see, our faith is more than a collection of Bible verses or do's and don'ts. We believe in a living relationship with Christ, the one who rose from the dead and is active in real ways in our lives. But God is not the only spiritual force in our cosmos. His enemy, the devil, is at work as well. We see his evil imprint all over the lies we'll explore here. After all, he is the author of lies. So why would the devil spend his time trying to destroy marriages? Because marriage is one of God's greatest and most glorious gifts. As we will see, marriage is about much more than just two people and their personal happiness. There are larger legacies at stake, and the devil wants to tear apart as many marriages as possible. We see his impact when men and women believe his lies and try to make them work in their marriages. We also see his power when he succeeds in turning men and women against each other. We know that some people think it's silly or medievally old-fashioned to talk about the devil impacting marriages for the worse, but that's just the way the devil likes us to remain, blind to all his varied schemes. We have seen the devil and his lies create hatred where there should be love, distance and division where there should be oneness and unity, and family separation and generational pain where there should be strong family legacies continuing generation after generation. Men and women need to realize there are supernatural forces at work in our lives and marriages. we shouldn't be surprised that the evil force wants to cause chaos and distrust in our relationships. The warnings Peter gave apply to couples. Be sober-minded. Be watchful. Your adversary the devil prowls around like a roaring lion, seeking someone to devour. 1 Peter chapter 5, verse 8. Paul also warned against the devil's schemes.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.